All right, look, I know it looks very, very early right now, but it's the fall of the year, so we've got these late sunrises, right? The sun is actually kind of coming up. The eastern horizon is brightening at least, but we're heading out today to go catch speckled trout. I've spent the past few days targeting reds, but I miss my beloved speckled trout, so back on the water today to try and intercept some. I got my son Joel with me and his buddy, Donny Steilberg. Is that right?
Yep.
I said it right. So we got a bit of a run right now. How's it going? We got a bit of a run right now, and then we're gonna go see if we can get on some trout. Hopefully once that sun comes up, the birds will start dipping and we'll get on some good action. That's the hope anyway. We'll see what happens.
All right, so we're starting this morning in a lake that I only remember fishing once in my life. It's a very, very good fall spot. Looks like we got pretty decent water conditions, but really the sun isn't up high enough yet to really tell. We're just throwing corks and making a long drift across this point just to see if we can find something. We got about a 5-knot east wind today, right now. It's supposed to pick up to 10 to 15. So I know it's gonna get pretty ugly here at some point. Hopefully get a few fish before that. It looks like the tide is falling, so that's good. They got a bunch of cuts over here. I don't want to fish off of, but this, the only chance we can fish this point is gonna be right now. Oh yeah, it's gonna get ugly. I know that. This wind's got a little bit of north in it. It's kind of weird.
Northeast.
Yeah, it's northeast, that's what it is. Northeast.
This is disappointing, man. Not even a throwback.
We're exploring, man. It takes
dude, I should be
takes time to figure things out. Dude, throwing a top water for what? Wouldn't you see any surface activity? Dude, if you can't catch them on a cork, you're not gonna catch them on a top water. We got good water clarity.
Wood.
We've got
no bait.
Decent conditions. We're gonna find some fish. Yeah, you gotta find a prey.
Oh, dude, Donnie's got a
prey. There we go. There's a trout. It's a little one, but it's a trout.
Whitey?
No, speck.
But he ate that thing.
All right, it's a start. It's a sign.
I'm just glad that Donnie sets the hook.
Yep.
This episode of Marsh Man Masson brought to you by Puglia Sporting Goods.
I'm just seeing all kind of bait up in here, see? See what I'm seeing? Look, punch us right into that shoreline. I think we're way too far out.
Fishing redfish now.
No, it's water's way up. It's high tide, and all the activity's up there. Nah, that's a throwback.
Hey,
he's got a shot.
He's definitely 12.
He's got a shot. He's got a shot. I think he might be 12. He's just, man, look how skinny. Look at that fish, how skinny. Look at that poor guy. No wonder he ate. It's the minute bowl of speckled trout. He is 12 and a half. All right, first keeper of the day. You know what you two clowns are doing? You know his, oh, fish on. Sorry, boys. Spotlight.
Hey.
Oh, I expect you to be that guy. It's another keeper. We will take him. That's about a 13 and a half inch fish. That's a better fish. Of course, people from out of town will give me hell for keeping this, but I don't really care because he's going to be so good to eat. Ooh, you saw what I saw, didn't you? That was a swim. Something busting it.
Look, man.
Oh, Donnie.
That was actually a pretty good takedown, too.
Was it?
I got him.
Never mind. Oh, there we go. He came back. That's a good fish. I mean, you know, relatively speaking, that's a keeper. Good job, Donnie. Uh-oh.
Oh no.
Uh-oh. Look out, boys.
We got 14 inches.
Did you spot lock it? Watch the motor. Dude, I got wrapped. I think you called me the other day when I was wrapped in the motor. Oh, goodness.
I give up. See, it could have went either way. You could have hit the rim.
Yeah, but apparently it's your bad luck day. Goodness. So let's see if you can get this one in the boat.
And that's 11.
No, I think he's a keeper. Yes, he's definitely a keeper. Definitely a keeper. I bet your college tuition. Dude, he ripped the rod out of my hands.
You think? Okay, I guess we won't measure him.
No, dude, I promise you, that fish is 13 all day.
Well, the water's got that look.
Let's put an end to that bite.
Perfect. Oh, Donnie's got a state record, dude. Damn, that actually is a good fish.
It actually is a state record. It's 13 inches. Oh, there we go. Feel keeper-like? Come on, man.
I'm gonna be optimistic, I guess.
There you go. Good. I like it. That's definitely a keeper. Yeah.
It's a white trout.
Oh, it's a whitey. That's 100% a keeper, then. It's not a bad whitey. Dude, Donnie can actually fish. I'm impressed. Most of your friends suck.
Oh, my bad.
This is Joel's first time on a boat.
Oh,
take down for Joel. But it's not in the boat yet.
You know it's small.
No, I think it's a keeper. Pretty sure it's a keeper. Hard to set the hook when I'm watching Donnie. I tell you what, he's going to have to go on the tape, but I think he is 12. Dude, I just ripped the rod out of my hands. I'm watching Donnie's fish trying to turn my body so the camera would be on it. Hopefully this one's 12. Spotlight. Look at this. Throw them on the floor, I'm measuring. I gotta measure mine as well. We got a handful. How about you?
They're there.
Yeah, they're there.
Scattered around.
They're a little scattered, exactly. There we go, there's a fish. I'm back on him. Look at my cord.
Yeah, that's good for the
It's a little tangled. Oh, I don't think he's gonna make it. Come on, dude. You think that fish is 12?
Good.
Spot luck. Hey, don't bite me.
Hey, he's 12, brother.
You mind if I measure him? Or should I just take your word for it?
See, I told you.
This episode of Marsh Man Masson brought to you by Matrix Shad and by Cito New Orleans and by Versamaxx Corks and by Deathgrip Jigheads.
Holy
shit. Oh, there we go.
They're right in his mouth.
Man, that might be a good 13 and a half incher. Wait, he's fighting.
What in
the freak? That's a keeper.
All right, so we're only maybe an hour into this fishing trip, and already we've exceeded expectations. Look, it's not December action, late November action. It's not that yet. The fish are not schooled up quite yet, but you don't expect them to be this time of year. It's still early October. The fish are scattered, so we're making long drifts, picking up fish here, fish there throughout the drift, hitting the spot lock when we get on some action, maybe catch three or four out of that area, and then we kind of move on. Now, the hot bait today is definitely a shrimp creole colored matrix shad. This bait has been hot really this whole fall. Heck, we're really not that far into fall, but you know, we had a really good September run and this was the bait. Now, I'm not going to tell you this is going to work everywhere because water clarities are different across the coast, but in this clearer water, this has been really good. It's always a good fall bait. Doesn't look anything to me like a white shrimp, but apparently that's what the fish think it is because that's when it works best. And we're fishing at about, I don't know, maybe 3 feet below a Versamaxx Bolt cork. The water we're fishing is about 4.5 to 5 feet deep. So you notice it's holding up about a foot and a half above the floor of this little area that we're drifting. Now we made a stop before we came in here and didn't see any bait at all. Really just didn't look good. And we came into this other area and there's lots and lots of bait. You know, fishing 101, right? You gotta find a bait to find a fish. Now a few boats have kind of moved in on us, which kind of sucks because we really want to resume our drift, but we're gonna have to play a little bit of dodge boat. But we'll see what happens on this drift. Now I can tell you almost always, your best drift is your first drift. Or at least that's what we find. So we're about to pick things up and go back and do it all again.
I was running
that. Guys. Well, Joel, you know what? That means you should be catching them. Nice. That's a keeper. Get him, Donnie. He hadn't come up, has he? No, he has.
That's a good trout right there. Hey, that is
a good fish. Good fish. Take 75 like that. Just drift.
Oh.
Dude.
One for the fish fry. Ow, I knew you were gonna bite me. I knew it. There you go. So unless you're a multimillionaire, you've probably got a few old rods in your arsenal. I know I do, and this is certainly one of them. I've had this rod forever, at least 15 years, and I still use it. It still holds up. So in pretty bad shape, missing the ceramic and the eye tip, but I use it only for speckled trout fishing, catching these little fish. It doesn't really matter. But eventually every rod wears out and certainly reels do. So bit of a commercial here. If you're in the market for a new rod and reel, go to Puglia Sporting Goods in Metairie, mention Marsh Man Masson, and they will give you 10% off your rod or reel purchase. You can't beat that, and I can tell you their prices are phenomenal anyway. So it's really almost like highway robbery. So go check it out. Mention Marsh Man Masson and get 10% off your rod and reel purchase.
I think if I had it.
There we go.
Oh, yeah.
Gill rattling frenzy, baby. Come on up, baby. You're going in a box. All right. Yep, it's a good fish too. He is not bad. 14 inches. He doesn't feel too big. All he's got to do though is hit the one and the two. Nah, I don't know. I don't think it's going to happen.
I think so.
Oh, yeah. I think it might. Oh, yeah. 12 and a half. Take down?
Donnie still got him. He's on.
I don't think he is.
Oh. Oh, man. The tiger shed. Mother.
He must be little.
No, dude. This is a tank. I think I followed him.
Seriously, that's a keeper. Good. All right, definitely kind of a mixed bag today. Things started really, really good, but that water temperature elevated, the wind picked up, and our trout just shut off, absolutely shut off. Not unexpected at all. Right now, it's the first week of October, and it's unseasonably hot here in South Louisiana. We've had no cold weather whatsoever. So those fish are kind of inside. They're not totally inside yet, but some of them are. But still, they're acting more like it's summer. They're just feeding in the morning, feeding in the evening, not feeding in the middle of the day. We went hunting for bass, went exploring new areas, found some stuff that looks really, really, really good. It just didn't work out. I don't understand it. Water's still high, very high. We're about at the peak of the high tide. It is falling, but it's not falling very quickly. And man, we got another 10 hours or so of this falling tide. Once that tide gets lower, closer to the bottom, I think those bass are really gonna go crazy. But Just couldn't make it work out. Still a successful day, and man, I'm looking forward to what's ahead. Right at the beginning of fall, my favorite season of the year. The fish is just so good this time of year, and it's definitely only gonna get better. All right, well, hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Also subscribe to the Marsh Man Masson channel on YouTube. And if you want some behind the scenes info, go check out our Patreon page. I'll put the web address right here. Until next time, if we don't see you in the marsh, we'll see you right here on Marsh Man Masson. Good luck.